We're breaking protocol here.
I didn't say that.
No, we're good friends.
That's all right. That's a good thing about being president. I can do whatever I want.
Well, you heard that. There is Obama telling the French socialist president, who's completely above the law, and the entire French socialist leadership is on record having giant Swiss bank accounts that are tax exempt, as they raise taxes on the middle class to 100%+ to claw back any savings that were kept back under the old 80%+ tax rate. And let's hear that one more time. Obama, I can do whatever I want. Best part about being president is I can do whatever I want while he's walking along talking to the French delegation and the French president.
All right, we're breaking protocol here.
I didn't say that. You're always good friends.
That's all right. That's a good thing about being president. I can do whatever I want.
So, did he not know there was a shotgun mic on him, or did he know? No, he knew, and it's all part of flaunting the lawless criminality in our faces. And he's there bragging, hey, I'm really good at killing people with drones. He's really manly. And he's really powerful. And he's really good at getting rid of the borders by fiat and shutting down the power plants by fiat and launching wars and getting peace prizes for it. And he's really good implementing Obamacare. That's a law that's completely unconstitutional that the blackmailed NSA spied on Supreme Court said, okay, it's constitutional as a tax to offshore banks that own the insurance companies. And the sky's the limit, ladies and gentlemen. That's why you're going to see government now go completely insane. It's already gone somewhat insane, but now it's going to go completely insane. Making it up as he goes, employer mandate delayed again. Obama rewrites Obamacare. Boehner is again trying to act like he is against Obama when he's actually working with him, but says that he exempts corporations, not families. And that's what we've been saying for 3 years looking at the bill. Also directly violates text of Affordable Care Act. Thought police, firms must swear Obamacare not a factor in firings. That's right. They're saying you're not allowed to tell people you're being fired over Obamacare. Front runner, nearing impossible to defend. Crowdhammer, this is the stuff you do in a banana republic. Doctors, astonished to find themselves listed on Obamacare exchange. It goes on. Fit gym members forced to pay new tax via Obamacare. Avalanche of new regs still to come. Obama, I can do whatever I want. That's up on drudgereport.com, a nice daily roundup of the nightmare that is Obamacare. But the trendies don't care. They like going from 40 hours to 30 hours. They like losing their jobs. They like the country going bankrupt. The chicest thing is to be like a hobo who doesn't work and doesn't take care of yourself. And women are, because the television tells them to, and women and men as well, imprint on whatever television says. So it says, throw yourself at the biggest loser. So the women just keep throwing themselves, believe me, I witnessed it in Austin, at the biggest losers they can in delusional mass psychosis narcissism. And then they just throw themselves at loser after loser, the dirtier, the dumber, the bigger the loser, the better they are. The bigger the winner, the worse you are. And then the women just keep waiting to, like, find Valhalla because television said they would get it. And the chicest thing is hobo clothing and living in dumpsters. We've got a Leanne McAdoo report on that coming up. And not having air conditioning and not having money. And it's just so stylish. It's so cool. Oh, my gosh, Obama. Obama, our Lord and Savior. Barack Obama. So it's all coming up today. David Icke, he's going to cover the waterfront with us. And the Green Beret himself. That's right. Special Forces Doctor Commando. You didn't know that. He never told anybody that until he found out about it. It makes him even cooler. Dr. Group will be in studio with us. The potential for the disastrous rise of misplaced power exists and will continue to persist. In modern parlance, that sounds like terrorist talk, according to Homeland Security. Watch out for the government. Watch out for tyranny. Watch out for tyranny right around the corner. Why, don't listen to those voices, as President Obama has said. There's no tyranny. Government's good. And it's here to help you. And the foreign offshore banks that run it, oh, they really want to help you like they've done all over the world. And Are you noticing what's happening to society? They're really helping everybody, aren't they, right now? Ladies and gentlemen, the Washington Times and others are reporting. Here's the headline. Gun owners beware. DC man faces jail for having empty shotgun shell. They SWAT team raid the successful businessman with no criminal record, including misdemeanors. Pointed guns at him and his wife, roughed him up, pulled the 16-year-old out of the shower, tore the place apart. He kept his guns at another home outside D.C. But they found a spent shotgun case, shotgun shell, plastic, and they are charging him, and he faces multi-years in jail, at least a one-year incarceration, and D.C. says they're going to throw the book at him. All because a disgruntled family member dropped a dime on him. That's what tyrannies are like. People make stuff up. And the establishment always responds viciously because they want to encourage the general public to join with the evil. About 80% of countries and nations, empires throughout history are hyper evil. That's a guesstimation, reading so much history. 8 times out of 10, they're really bad. The other 20%, it varies from bad to somewhat free. But most governments are tyrannies, and they just get worse and worse from there until everything collapses. And we are now seeing this unfold here. I mean, the news I've got yesterday, I saw an article up on drudgereport.com. It's still red-linked up on Drudge Report. We did some video reports on this last night that are up on Infowars.com. David Knight covered it. National Guard trains to fight anti-government Second Amendment supporters. That's a quote. And they train where the school teachers are conservative gun owners, so they bioweapon the town and start shooting everyone. And they're training as if this is the new scenario. This article, Drudge links to the Media Trackers article, that's a big article, but the original is WSAZ out of Ohio, and then the Examiner says feds identify Second Amendment activists as terrorists. Yeah, and what's really going on is the scripting. This is what a re-education camp looks like on a mass scale, where in the dramas, the TV shows, the movies, the cartoons, the bad guys, the child molesters, the meth dealers, the child kidnappers, the torturers, the devil worshipers, the people that are going to blow the school up are all the gun-owning patriots that like George Washington. Literally, if you watch television, you see it. It's just everywhere. Bone-chilling. Now, this was going on secretly under Clinton when we discovered it and got classified secret documents and made national news with it. Now, and I've told you this the last 5 years, it's operational. They've gone public with it. Do you know what that means? They're not doing this behind the scenes, ladies and gentlemen. They're rolling it out in almost every drill now of attacks on shopping malls and attacks on schools. And we've covered this, you know, the AP's covered it, where the homeschoolers in Michigan, all over the state, they call out the elementary kids, blow up a bus or a car that Homeland Security pays for, scare the kids, don't even tell them it's a drill, and then have people in camo come up and say, I'm for homeschooling and the Second Amendment, I'm going to blow your brains out. And the kids get totally traumatized, and the police go, we only know about the ones where the parents freak out and sue. We're sorry, won't do it again. It was a federal grant. I've had the school teachers on, one from Minneapolis, with her lawyer. This was 10 years ago. This is going on under Bush as well. It's a continuity of agenda. Where they took them out one of these drills and said, we're here for the Second Amendment. We're going to kill you because you're anti-Second Amendment. And they lined everybody up, including the teacher. She had to quit her job and had a mental break because for 20 minutes they said, prepare to die, and didn't tell them it was a drill. That was in the local paper. They was like, did it go too far? This is mind control. How many cases you heard where they have the kids at camp, at a public school camp, and they come with a guy with a knife and a gun and go, I'm going to kill you, and teach the kids to hide under the desk or whatever. A lot of times they don't even tell them, or they tell parents, there's going to be a shooting drill. Don't bring your kids, you know, next Thursday if you don't want to be part of it. Well, the parents still stick their kids in it, and it is, I've shown you the news clips, crying little kids with guys in hoods going, I'm for the Second Amendment, I'm going to kill you. I mean, we're talking freak level mind control, ladies and gentlemen. Freak level. And it's going on everywhere, and now it's on the TV everywhere, and it's in sitcoms and dramas and children's shows. Jakari Jackson had a report on it last year, where he shows all these cartoons, Green Lantern, the new Super Friends, all of it, all these shows where the militia's like wearing tri-corner hats going, we believe in America and the right to bear arms. We're going to blow up the dam and kill everybody in the town. This is mind control. They are scripting that we're the terrorists, folks. And let me tell you what they're going to do. If we don't get them off balance and make a big deal out of this, everybody's saying, oh, Obama's done. He's been damaged. He's a dead duck politically. You know, he's a lame duck. No, they're not. This is the most dangerous time in American history, undoubtedly on every front. Folks, that's why he's running around saying, got caught on video in France saying, I can, quote, do whatever I want. In fact, let's just play that clip right now in case people just joined us. This is out right now from the Weekly Standard. It's also up on Infowars.com. Here it is.
All right, we're breaking protocol here.
That's
all right. That's the good thing about being president. I can do whatever I want.
And he's doing whatever he wants on every front. And he's really good at killing people. So he gets a peace prize. And ladies and gentlemen, they're going full court now. I've got articles here where when police pull people over who have concealed carry, they are telling them, you know, get out, get on the ground. I want your gun. I want to know where it is. And the guy's like, it's at home. So they blow up on him even more. And it's all on squad car video. And it's happening to concealed carry people all over the country now. With the new police, they're training under federal guidelines that when you've got a concealed carry, a lot of times they'll just go ahead and get that gun out right up to your head. Because you're the terrorist. And they go home and watch all these cop shows and these dramas and movies where the guy that's going to nerve gas New York is an Alex Jones listener. This isn't a game. And they're scripting it so when they blow stuff up and release bioweapons, you name it, blow up dams, you name it, sky's the limit, people will already believe, yeah, they kept saying these guys were going to do it. This is the most obvious frame-up I've ever seen in my life. I mean, this is like if your neighbor ran around for a week saying, you know, Bill's a cocaine dealer, Bill's a cocaine dealer, and then, you know, you call the cops come pull over Bill, and there's the cocaine in the back, right where Bob, the neighbor, said it was. Any smart police would say, you know, how did you know about that? Oh, I don't know, I just knew. Let's take you in for questioning. It's so obvious the frame-up is going on. And through all cultures and all history, it's the same type of people that rise up and take over until the people stand up against them. And let me quantify why I'm making such a big deal out of gun owners being persecuted everywhere, Bloomberg being caught in secret meetings, 50 mayors quitting, more today when they said the plan is to register and confiscate. They're trying to line up the cities, the states, everybody for the criminal takeover. And here's the big news. The military and the police have been trained covertly and directed for war with the American people with the key officer-level cadres for 20-plus years, conservatively. Now they have expanded it down to the lower ranks, have given civil unrest and gun confiscation training to almost all of the armed services at every level, and are accelerating demonization, propaganda, brainwashing, not against just guns like Holder ordered the media to do. We have that clip of him publicly on C-SPAN saying it. So they have to act in the open like it's no big deal because it's so outrageous. This is a criminal, racketeering conspiracy against this free country. This is a foreign banking coup d'etat with a bunch of socialist, communists, and other people who have a real score to settle with Americana, who are going to be the enforcers, literally persecuting the living daylights out of people. And it will become a self-fulfilling prophecy where people have no other choice but to fight back. See, we're then going to be the terrorists. They are lining the country up for civil war directed by the occupied federal government. And they are going operational everywhere, preparing the police and telling them veterans are going to IED your police department and your vehicles. You need armored vehicles. You are going to be attacked by gun owners and veterans and libertarians. You are going to be attacked by the Tea Party. The Pentagon is shifting to its main NORTHCOM directive. Is not stopping cruise missiles coming in off Chinese subs, folks. This is public. It is war with anybody that is half decent. And a lot of you know this is true now. It's all going public. You're deciding to join with the evil, aren't you? Because you're cowards. You'll play along with it when they blow up a sports stadium or a dam or a school or nuke a city and say the Patriots did it. And you'll line up and you'll go out and you'll arrest and hand us over to the mercenaries who'll go kill us. It isn't going to happen like that. People very quickly are not going to just sit there when you come. They're going to go on the offense, which is the best defense. And they're going to roll out, and no amount of hardware is going to help you. I mean, you can't hold Baghdad with 300,000 U.S. troops, 100,000 of them in Baghdad. You think you're going to hold this country? We've already identified you. Everybody already sees you're not cloaked. You're not operating in the dark. You're operating at high noon, and everybody sees it coming down. And my job is to back these people off and to be bold enough to tell it like it is, to be bold enough to be honest, to risk my life so that we have a chance to stop these people. And the least you can do if you work in the system as a bureaucrat, as a data miner, as a police officer, as a psychologist, as a doctor, as a social worker, as a teacher, as a bureaucrat, as a banker, is start leaking intel to the people, start not complying quietly, and the system counts on compliance. It's basically weak. You empowered it. You've got to speak out against it. You've got to identify friends and people that know what's going on. You've got to start resisting. You've got to create under nom de plumes your own website, your own YouTubes, your own pen names. You can operate publicly, not publicly, but the general public has to look in the mirror and not just blame the bureaucracy. We let this bureaucracy turn into this. You want to know who the problem is? Look in the mirror. As V from Vendetta says, I know why you did it. We ought to come back and play the clip where he takes over the TV station. Go to YouTube and type in, or we've got it back there on DVD in Dew's office, or we used to. But people use this place like a library. It's not bad, but stuff comes and goes. The point is that it's the part where he says, I know why you did it. You wanted it to be easy. You wanted to believe everything was okay. You wanted to give your liberty over to somebody else to protect you. But now you know you're a slave. What are you going to do about it? Oh, there are some that are more guilty than others, and they will be dealt with. But if you want to know who's really behind it, look in the mirror. We all have to put in the maximum effort right now. Or I'm telling you, the clock's ticking, folks. They are getting ready to stage false flags and blame it on us. What do you think Boston was? What do you think Sandy Hook was? Ahead of David Icke joining us and ahead of Dr. Group being in studio, Dr. Edward Group, I want to open the phones up right now to police currently serving in the homeland and to currently serving military or recently out, that could even be the last decade, who have been part of these now public drills where the gun owners, libertarians, veterans, again, number one enemy returning veterans are cast as the bad guy. I mean, imagine if they were having drills where black people are going to go kill everybody at the school, or where Hispanics are, or where Catholics were, or Jews were. There would be an incredible outcry. But, oh, veterans as a group. Oh, gun owners. Oh, libertarians. Oh, conservatives. Oh, Bob Barr supporters. Remember that in the Mike report? Oh, Ron Paul supporters. Yeah, oh, they're terrorists, police. Go ahead and arrest them. I saw that in Law Enforcement magazine years ago. It said, you know, they got to get us out of the UN sticker from the John Birch Society. Go ahead and take them in. And chiefs, you support them. We're sure there's something they're doing wrong. Statistically, folks, John Birchers are probably the lowest crime rate of anybody out there. And everybody knows that who studies history, criminology. I mean, I can't think of more upstanding people than the John Birchers I've known in my life. I'm not even part of the group. But they list them as evil terrorists, basically. The more upstanding you are, the more you won't sell out, the stronger you are, the more committed you are, of course you're listed as an enemy by this criminal takeover. Of course, clean-cut, hard-working veterans that own businesses are being watched. because they're scared of you. These crooks are scared of men and women who have honor in their hearts and who want freedom. And we're being listed as the terrorist. I am listed as someone who wants violence and a revolution on MSNBC and CNN. Because I tell them, I know you're preparing for war with us, and if you try it, 1776 will commence again. Those aren't just words. We're taking action. They said, there's no open carry in San Antonio. We don't care what the state law is. And over 1,000 people marched down there in defiance, and the police backed off and did their duty. But after we left that night, they arrested somebody open carrying right there. It's disgusting. They think they're playing it safe. You're not playing it safe. You got to do like the sheriff of Liberty County, Florida. He read the statute on air with us. I read the statute when he got arrested. The sheriff. And it said if someone's going to or from work or transporting money, they can have a concealed firearm in the vehicle for their security without a permit. But if you feel that they were transporting it outside of that, it's written where they can, written, it's a bad statute. He said, listen, you arrested this guy with no criminal record for a gun coming from his work? Let him go. He said to his deputies, you want to carry guns off duty too, don't you? You like, I mean, let him go. Get rid of that fake report. They arrested him. The governor tried to make sure he went to jail. The jury, no building. The jury said not guilty. Grand jury with no bill. It was the jury and the court trial. Because they're afraid of the enforcers deciding to follow their oath. They're scared to death, so they want to intimidate you. That little police chief out in that small town of New Mexico, when he got to the airport to fly into Las Vegas to be part of a constitutional sheriff's meeting, and he went in there, and they harassed him and sent the feds in trying to get him fired, and the Fed was there knowing what he was going to, knowing what he was doing. And then now a lady's reading a conservative Jewish newspaper and they interrogate her for 30 minutes and rifle her stuff. They're thought police, folks. When I go to the airport, the low-level TSA will be like, oh, hi, Alex, how you doing? And the manager will walk over and go, well, Jones, where are you going and what you planning? And I'll say, well, you know you've got my ticket. Answer my questions if you want to fly. It's all about lining me up, teaching me I'm a criminal, teaching me, and next is, come with us, and that's already starting. Come with us at the airport, that's an internal checkpoint, and you disappear. And then, oh, don't say anything about Alex, they might get you. No, we all got to stand together against this evil of illegitimate criminals. They will succeed and take over if you're afraid of them, folks. You should be scared to death of not taking action. History, facts, my gut, everything says, fight these people head on, call them out, speak out against them. And the minute, the reason they'll come after us when they stage a false flag, and I know that, is they know we've got reporters and myself and auxiliary reporters around the country that are going to go to their press conferences. When they stage a Boston bombing or an event, we're going to have our people there in hours. We're going to expose the drills, the setup. We're going to get the photos the FBI says don't look at. They had Secret Service, when Obama wasn't even there, come and threaten Dan Bondi with all sorts of bodily harm if he kept asking questions at the in the press conference about the drill. And the FBI looked at the media and they said, you do not talk to this man or look at his photos. And the media literally saluted, except a few national media came over and said, we know it's a drill. They're killing people. They're finding them dead in the rivers. Man, you know, you got a lot of courage. People can make jokes about people like Bondi because he's a real normal guy and everything and is, you know, up there with his East Coast accent, but he's a real guy who's got courage, not once, not twice, but three times to have feds come up and start bumping into him going, you better watch it, punk. You know something's going to happen. He said, fine, do whatever you're going to do. I'm going to ask the questions. He's not a coward. You people in this gang system that think, you know, you've got all the power because you've got the system. You've got all this power from sucking off the people. And you got a traitor government saying the veterans and gun owners are the number one threat. That's like Hitler did. This is so flaming tyrannical. This is on fire with evil. This is outrageous. Outrageous how naked this is. How brazen. How belligerent. And it doesn't take a rocket scientist to know. They've already done all the TV conditioning, all of it. Their plan I'm going to open the phone number up for police and military, and I'll go right to you because we got David Icke coming up. I want to hear what you think about a guy with a shotgun case, spent casing, literally that they dug through all of his hunting and fishing stuff and, you know, and found it in a vest he'd forgotten to take out. And they're going to try to put him in jail for years in D.C. I want to know what you think about Bloomberg getting caught in secret meetings saying once we register, we're going to ban. I want to know what you think about the federal grants you get where you go and you train at public schools to condition the kids that the gun owners are going to come kill everybody because they're mad about the Second Amendment being violated. And they're going to use bioweapons, that the school biology teachers are terrorists. They had some glitter on a poster out in California a few months ago, and some of it blew. And they said, you're trying to make people think there's a bio attack. They've got people where there's a backpack on the ground. I mean, I've been at the airport before and walked off with my bags to get a coffee, and people are like, hey, your bags. I'm like, Starbucks is 10 feet. I know. My crew's sitting right by the bag, lady. It's always a woman. Nothing against women, but they're the ones that are more congenial in tribal situations to try to comply and be nice people. The problem is you got evil running the country. And repeatedly, I have had one time at Austin Bergstrom, I got up to go get some barbecue. I mean, some utensils for my barbecue, and I was waiting to fly out. And a woman again went, sir, don't leave your bag. And it was literally 15 feet to the paper towels and utensils. This woman is shaking in fear that there's terrorists everywhere when the government runs the terrorists publicly on record. And that's all out in the open now. So they're segueing from forget Al-Qaeda, why it's the gun owners. I mean, this is incredible. And we've got to make this break into the media and have a serious talk about this. I mean, remember what came out last year? We first broke it. Leaked to us, actually, out of a PSYOPs group. I mean, I'll just say it because they're all being tracked. They know it. They're not. They don't care. Out of Fort Hood, where they said the evangelical Christians are criminals. You are not to give money or go to one of their churches or be part of the Tea Party, or you will be called before the man and court-martialed. And then Fox News picked it up. And they went, okay, the Secretary of the Army said, we're going to stop that now. Man, I mean, imagine. This is like a Soviet takeover, folks. This is the real deal ahead of them going operational, and then all hell's going to break loose forever, basically. The end of our way of life, the end of prosperity, dead citizens, dead police, dead military, hell on earth. I mean, this is a nightmare situation where the globalists play us off against each other. So at the end of this segment, the next segment, and the next one, I want to talk to police and military. We only got time for a few, but I want you to call in right now. Give me your take on this. 800-259-9231. 800-259-9231. I've already talked too long. I promise I'll go right to you when you come in. Go ahead. We've opened the phones up. 800-259-9231. Briefly, I've never been more alive than I am now to be taking action into the face of this thing. And this is what we're all born to do. Every generation goes through different struggles. We're going through a very serious one. One of the greatest humanity's ever seen. And history's happening right now. So nobody should say that they're bored. Please support us. Please get the fine products at InfoWarsLife.com, the survival shield, radiation protection, overall thyroid and other body health. This has done wonders for so many people. The Super Male Vitality that helps block all the estrogen mimickers that are being put in everything. The Fluoride Shield that I think is really the best value, Nation Iodine and five other ingredients known to detox. InfoWarsLife.com. InfoWarsLife.com or 888-253-3139. InfoWarsStore.com has the survival seeds, non-GMO at the lowest prices, the widest selection, the books, the films, the Molon Labe t-shirts came in today. They're going up on the shopping cart today. It's the best Molon Labe come and take it design out there. Bar none, incredible job that one of our old graphics guy got to do it, that Cade did. It's just unbelievable. So that's going to be going up on the shopping cart later today. 800-800. You can go 888-253-3139, 888-253-3139 to call online or InfoWarsStore.com, obviously. But again, I get in a hurry plugging in and start babbling in 18 other directions. I'm so freaked out about how obvious all this is and the fact that we've got to get the public to realize this is happening that I can hardly even talk at some points. Let's go to Steve, who's in Pennsylvania and I guess is active duty military. Steve, what is your take on all this? Do you think I'm wrong, or what do you think? Let's pot Steve up there on the network for me real quick. Go ahead, Steve. You're on the air.
You there?
Yes. Yes. Go ahead.
Yeah, you're dead on. I was in the military for 6 years. I just got out the other year. And I woke up beginning of last year, and it seems like everything you've been saying for the past year or so has been right on. No doubt about it.
And I can't even believe a real takeover is being attempted right now. Even I can't believe it's really happening, even though we saw all the signs. And even though it's happened in other countries over and over again. But it's so crazy. Imagine the majority of drills are for veterans and gun owners killing children to demonize veterans, gun owners, and conservatives. I mean, this is outrageous. Where is the Republican Party hauling the Attorney General up for impeachment right now?
Well, you can't trust either party.
I know.
They're the problem is they're both, you know, joined together at the hip. That's the problem.
Well, let me ask you this. When you were in, before you got out a year ago, were you ever part of these drills? Because I've been to them that are public, where they train to fight guys that literally have beards and wear John Deere hats. Basically, they train to fight Hank Williams Jr. Were you ever part of that, or did you ever hear about any of those drills?
I was never a part of those drills, but we did have a company come in from, they were doing a video for West Point, and they actually asked some of us to go and work with this film crew and stuff because we have a large National Guard base about 10 minutes from my house where my unit used to be at. And we had this little training town that was out there in the middle of the woods. And we'd go out there and they'd make videos of us kicking down doors and all sorts of other stuff for training videos. But I was never part of an actual drill.
Exactly, and West Point is now publicly training, but the main enemy is the Tea Party. That's in Forbes, Associated Press, you name it. But the AP reports it like it's a good thing. Thank God the Pentagon's going to smash people that don't want to turn their guns in and have the state run their kids. Go ahead.
Well, when I was in, you know, I always told all my guys that were in my platoon or in my company or anybody that was lower enlisted, you know, remember your oath. And even now, since I'm out in the IRR right now, even though I'm out, I still talk to, like, military officers. I still talk to my old soldiers I used to serve with. And I still tell them, remember your oath. I mean, we all swore an oath to protect and defend the Constitution of the United States against all enemies, foreign and domestic. So we all have to live by that oath. I live by mine every day. Last year, since the Sandy Hook shooting, and I looked into all that and found out it was mostly a hoax that was perpetrated by our government. I've been looking into, you know, and researching everything that goes on now. I've been calling my congressman every week, every 2 weeks, to make sure they get the point across, hey, you ain't getting our guns.
Exactly. Everybody's just got to continue to speak to friends and family. We're the majority. We're the Americana culture. The culture of America isn't perfect, but it's a billion times better than the globalist synthetic slave culture. God bless you. And ladies and gentlemen, you know, Cy Hirsch, the Pulitzer Prize-winning two-time investigative journalist, he came out last year and concurred with us and said the bin Laden raid was 100% fake. I talked to an active-duty Navy SEAL that's friends of the family, I'll leave it at that, weeks after it happened. I've had family of people that died in the helicopter that was blown up on saying they know it was set up to kill their family and they were killing, the Navy SEALs were sent in on a bin Laden body double. We even know the guy's name. And now, today, they've come out, and it turns out the Pentagon claimed they had photos of it and video and all this stuff. And then, quote, when they were ordered to declassify it, it was, quote, all destroyed. It was fake. They court-martialed hundreds of people on the ship, the aircraft carrier. Now it turns out there was no body dumped overboard. That's come out in mainstream news. It's all lies, folks. He died of kidney failure a long time ago. He was a high-level globalist asset above CIA. It's all fake. And yes, we don't know exactly what happened with Sandy Hook, but we got a good idea. They've bulldozed it. They've covered it up. Real kids were killed there, but they did have confirmed actors putting out the official story, and Bloomberg got caught in internal memos that have been leaked preparing the day before for the big push and saying, prepare now for the news blitz. That's that. Look it up, folks. I mean, it is incredible. And they just count on everybody's ignorance to not understand this is real. I mean, this is so horrible. I wish this wasn't true. You know, it's like when I got the word my uncle was basically brain dead and was going to be turned off and die. And I was going to get out there, but he died really quick after they took him off. They thought he'd fight a few days. It's like I've now accepted he's dead and he's gone. And we have to accept America is pretty much dead. But it's like a spirit. It's not a person. It could be resurrected in our hearts and minds if we want. Not the perfect America the media has pushed, but the real America that at least has basic freedom compared to other nations. We're in deep trouble, folks. This is real. And I'm having to come to grips with, man, it's really as bad as we thought and worse. With a bunch of scum that have got a score to settle with people that love freedom. Let's go to Glenn in Kentucky, who's police, then Raymond, who's military, and Rabbit, who's military. Go ahead, Gene. What's your take on all this?
Yes, sir. My cousin just recently retired from Kentucky State Police, 20-plus years, PR officer. And his direct response to your story on the illegal checkpoints is highly decorated. You can check him out if you wanted to. I can give you your name off air, make sure that it's who it is. But he says, well, I must chime in here and explain the constitutionality of the RAID program. Folks think there is a God-given right to drive a car on the roads without being bothered by the police. That's the furthest thing from the truth. Bottom line, driving is a privilege and not a right under state law. Now, can a police officer stop someone in a traffic stop for no reason? No. Checkpoints have been ruled constitutionally legal as long as the encounter is quick and to the point. Can I see your license and registration? Of no apparent violations, send them on their way. Being a Commonwealth...
But then they release illegals when they find them. No, I've seen those quotes in the news. Now they're looking for people with food in the car or who look like they might have been eating, and then they pull you over and go, have you been eating? Okay, here's a ticket. It's pure conditioning. I appreciate your call because we're going to police and military as quick as we can. Let's talk to Raymond in Illinois, listening on WCKG in Chicago. You're military. Are you current, or did you just get out, and what's your take on this?
No, sir. I've been out for some time now. I have a son that's in, and my comment was they are gearing up. The Masons, I live in a small town. The Masons have been having meetings quite frequently. Wisconsin, all the major roadways, they're putting gates on the overpasses, barricades.
Well, I know this. They are getting all the kind of the insiders and all the cities ready for collapse and telling wealthy families, hey, be part of the system. We can protect you. Acting like they don't know why the collapse is coming. The globalists engineered all this. That's the point. See, that's why they staged the crisis, is because they can pose as the savior.
Well, I know that. You woke me up quite a few years ago, and I've woken up a few members of my family, but there's others that don't want to listen. That you know.
Oh, yeah, no. You'll have 300-yard-wide mediums all over the U.S., and they're putting cables down the middle of them. It's got to be billions of dollars nationwide, so you can't. I mean, it's for control, and they admit it's for that. I mean, this is just hellish what they're doing. God bless you, sir. I appreciate your call. Rabbit in the Midwest, are you former or current military?
Former.
So what's your take on all the TV shows, everything demonizing gun owners?
Well, I'm sure you can talk to David Icke about this a little bit more. But surprisingly or not, I think it's a good thing in terms that it will cause the spiritual evolution which America needs to reboot itself morally and on an individual level.
I hear you. I appreciate the call, Rabbit. But, I mean, I want police and military to call in. They call in all the time, and I don't ask them to. They've been part of these gun confiscation drills. But now they're on record in the news. They're training all over the country to fight gun owners and saying we're terrorists, we're going to blow stuff up and kill kids, demonizing us ahead of a political purge, folks. I haven't even gotten to all the top stories on Infowars.com yet, and I'll do that some with David Icke covering the waterfront coming up here. But every week we get more local news reports just where it leaks out where the military is training with police to take on gun owners, veterans, and billing them as terrorists in the drills where they shoot, blow up schools, release bioweapons because, quote, they're mad about the Second Amendment being repealed. And there are going to be a lot of people. I'll imagine it's going to be about 5% at first that refuse to turn their guns in openly. Most people just quietly won't do it. I'd say half. Then they're going to start persecuting gun owners, as they're already doing. And then a civil war is going to break out. And that's what the globalists have already scripted and prepared, like a PR rollout. And, I mean, no one should want to be part of this. This is horrible. But they've got to do this to cover up the economic collapse they've engineered so they don't get in trouble. This is a plan, folks, and we're just getting so close to it. Garrett in Austin, military, to give us your take on this. What's your take on it?
Wow, Alex, great to talk to you. Been trying to get hold of you for some time. First off, a little background information on me. I served in security forces guarding nuclear assets in Bremerton, Washington, up in the Pacific Northwest. One quick note, once I got out, the base commander there, the leading officer of the base, got taken out and fired for alleged forgery charges. I didn't think much of it at the time, but now you see this huge purge in the all the nuclear programs of all the leading officers over the across the board. It kind of made me think about it.
No, this but, is a this is a purge of the military by the Obamanoids and Goldman Sachs and J.P. Morgan that run the country.
Well, and you know, my take on what's going to happen, to be perfectly honest with you, I'm thinking it's going to be a lot like Egypt. If you're anybody who's in the military or has been in the military, they see that it works literally like a communist country. If you live on base, all the houses are lined up. They all look the same. They come check your rooms anytime they want. They come make sure you're always doing what you're supposed to, making sure you eat your meals every day. Before you go on vacation, you have to go to what's called a safety stand down. It's you go to the auditorium. They have to teach you about chainsaw safety, about boat safety, about barbecue safety. It's the craziest thing ever, and it's the reason they want the military to take over once the Civil War breaks out, in which they're going to do exactly like they've done in Egypt and Syria and plant different al-Qaeda-linked groups or any other terrorist organizations. They probably have paid contractors that they'll send in to work and act as if they're the rebels and do atrocities and then have the military take over. Everybody that's in the military has been trained to respect authority, brainwashed. And those of them who've gotten out that are veterans, that's why they're demonized today, because they're either going to be completely compartmentalized and ruled by that authoritarian mindset that they've been brainwashed to think, or they're going to be completely against it like me and have their eyes open to how evil it is and be completely willing to fight back and know how the system works, and that's why they're the greatest enemy out there right now. And but, you know, all the people that are in the military, they're already trained to respect the authority to, you know, they've already been trained. I give up my constitutional right when I sign that paper, and because I signed this contract, I have nothing I can do.
And now the cops are saying, hey, you have no right to not be in a checkpoint or have a search your house. Everything's a privilege. Guns are a privilege. Driving's a privilege. They believe it. And, man, I mean, every cartoon I see, movies, they're demonizing the resistance. I mean, this is it. And, folks, I'm not here trying to scare you. We got a chance to beat these people. What they're trying is outrageous. Go ahead.
I just wanted to quickly add, I got out of the military because I admit that I was a lot of us were smoking what's called spice. I'm sure you've heard of it. I would never do it again. Never, you know, we were just really depressed. We hated our lives there. But there was a lot of drug activity going on that base. Well, they came into my room in the middle of the night, took me and confined me in the brig for 2 months without charging me with.
Well, yeah, and they also give the troops drugs, the prescription to prime the pump. That way they get a record on you and a way to destroy you. Everything is about institutionalizing us, domesticating us, breaking us. The planet is being looted. The populations are being poisoned via genetically engineered foods, chemicals that are added to the water. The television, the mainline dinosaur television, is literally weaponized media there to destroy individualism, destroy families. And that's their own stated goal. Obama, hanging out with the French president, says, I can do whatever I want. I'm basically a dictator. That's a new video we played 3 times in the last hour. Obama says he can implement any part of law he wants outside of law. And the same thing's being done all over the world. In Europe, the top socialists are tax-exempt and put their money in Swiss bank accounts. They even get caught and don't get in trouble. There is a racing of tyranny taking place right now. And meanwhile, in the United States, they're reporting in Fox News, thought police. See how radical even mainline media is getting? Because Radical things are happening. Firms must swear Obamacare not a factor in firings. And Obama exempts his friends and big corporations from it, but not families. A tax to the big insurance companies to bring in government-run death care. All over the place, we are seeing unbelievable, bizarro-level tyranny unfold. And in the Big Brother area, MBTA buses get live video technology. The CBS News is reporting out of Boston, feeding live video feeds back to Homeland Security. Remember when they said the cameras weren't for law enforcement? Your iPhone's watching you, your computer's tracking you, all the new appliances are tracking you. They're just rolling out a revolution. Virgin Atlantic to have Google glasses watching you and recording everything you do on their flight attendants. They're just rolling out the control grid, fingerprint and eye scanning drones to make deliveries in United Arab Emirates. It is simply incredible. And here's a few of the headlines at InfoWars.com. Then we go to David Icke for the balance of the hour. Video, jihadist rebels in Syria backed by NATO strangle woman to death, blow up hundreds of churches. Go watch the video. See what the Peace Prize president supports. Government task forces cannot protect women from rape. True feminism is about arming women, not disarming them. Washington state legislation ending illegal drone surveillance gains bipartisan support. An exclusive report from our Washington state reporter, Mikhail Phelan. DOD gave order to destroy bin Laden death photos hours after Freedom of Information Act request. Cy Hurst says the raid never happened. It was staged. Yes, we know. See how it's all coming out? Video. Police shoot dogs. Family service dog outside 9-year-old's birthday party. 19 statistics about the drugging of America that are almost too crazy to believe. 20% of the public's now on drugs. Government-issued drugs. Now they want 50% on it. Crowdhammer on Obama employer mandate. This stuff is right out of a banana republic. That is just some of what's going on right now. But shifting gears, he's got a new book out. He's launched his own TV channel on mainline television in England. Truth is Rising. David Icke of DavidIcke.com joins us. Always thought-provoking. So much of what he said 20 years ago that I certainly laughed at, unfortunately, turned out to be true. He exposed people to the BBC that he said were having necrophilic sex with children they'd murdered and everything else. And it all came out a decade after he named names. I mean, it is unbelievable. And I just bite my tongue hoping that, you know, the rest of it doesn't turn out to be true. I'm just pinching myself. But David Icke joins us, one of the most controversial guests you can have on. And we're always honored to have him. I've had a chance to hang out with him over the years, get to know him. Just a really real guy. People ask, is David Icke for real? Yes, he's for real. Is he right about everything? I don't think any of us are right about everything because we see through rose-colored glasses, you know, the distortion of our senses in the time-space continuum. But so much is happening. The Great Awakening is happening that he said 20 years ago he thought would begin around 2014 through 2016, 2017. And it's evils rising, but for every action, there's an opposite and equal reaction. So much is going on. The global collapse is being engineered as the New World Order poses the saviors. They're all over the news, adding deadly chemicals to everything on purpose to brain damage us. Their own documents are public by the White House science czar, John P. Holdren, in his own book, Eco-Science. DNA results for the Nephilim skulls, mainstream news. They've tested those weird Peruvian skulls and say it's a new form of humans. I mean, this is all just getting insane. And more is going to happen. More and more is going to be revealed. And people are going to get deeper into the matrix and lies and false reality at the same time as others become more awakened. I agree with David Icke on that. So, David, give us the big picture of where you think we are, what you think the top stories are right now, and what you think is coming. And then we'll cover the waterfront with a whole bunch of news. David, thanks for coming on with us.
No problem, mate. Hey, it's been a while, isn't it? Bilderberg, wasn't it? In Watford, the last time we met. And first of all, congratulations. The big 4-0, eh?
That's right. I'm 40 today. It's strange you're on my birthday, David. Thanks for coming on.
There you go. Well, I'm 62, so you know, you're a whippersnapper, mate. Long time ago, yeah. I think, you know, we are reaching the point now. We've reached the point where so many strands of this are coming together. And if you connect the dots between the strands, it's challenging us to open our minds to things that we would have dismissed by reflex action not so long ago. I've been saying for two decades that the rabbit hole is so deep that if we're only looking at things like banking scams and engineered wars and engineered terrorist attacks, etc., which is very, very important to expose, but we're still walking around the edge of the rabbit hole. This is so deep. And we have to, I would suggest, open our minds to the fact that there are forces at work in the unseen, which Christians call demons, which Islamic believers call jinn, which other people call archons, other people call flyers in Central America, the shaman. There is an unseen force manipulating this. And the idea is to put humans into such a low state of consciousness and awareness that the manipulating force becomes the one-eyed man in the land of the blind.
So they basically want us to be robots. David, I love seeing your huge newsroom back there, but unfortunately your omnidirectional mic is picking up everything they're saying. I want to hear what you have to say. Can somebody shut that door?
I'll do that.
Thanks a lot, brother. All right, good. I do like the shot, though, but it seemed when we went on air, the noise volume went up. So
yeah.
It looks like you got an anthill of liberty lovers in there running around getting stuff done. Please continue, David. So they want to turn us into robots, basically.
Yeah, and, go ahead. They want to put us in a smaller perception, a bubble, than the manipulating forces in. Like I say, in the land of the blind, the one-eyed man is king. And you know, in terms of things going on now, fundamental to pushing that further on is transhumanism. The idea is to sell us the belief that we can be enhanced by technological additions to the body. And this, Alex, we've talked about this over the years. This is bringing to like what I've said about the human body all these years, that it's a biological computer. And because it's a biological computer, it can be connected and can interact with other forms of computer software, i.e. technological computers. You see, what you've got, there was a story this week in Britain about the invention of an artificial hand, which for the first time gave the person the ability to feel things, to feel texture, to feel the softness of something that had never been done before. They could move it and pick things up before, but they could never feel things. And it's a real simple process in theme. There are electrical signals passing around the brain, and there are electrical signals that pass around the technology.
It's electrochemical, and the brain has no firewall.
Basically, what they're doing is making those two forms of energetic information talk to each other. And that, so the hand talks to the brain that way, and therefore the brain can decode the feeling of texture and touch. So what we're looking at then with transhumanism is putting in various technological bits of kit and stuff, and connected it to the human body, the biological computer. And it's being sold, like I say, as a great step forward to beyond human, amazing things that humans can do. That's the sell. Because whenever you are selling something, whatever it is, the mobile phone technology connected to the smart meter technology, connected to the smart television technology, whenever you are selling something that's real bad for the target population, you have to sell it as a benefit. Otherwise, people are going, we're not having that. You've got to sell.
Oh, Virgin Atlantic has Google glasses. Oh, my refrigerator talks to my smart meter. Oh, it's all so wonderful.
This is the thing. And so what the real agenda is not enhancing human beings. They don't want greater potential for human beings. They want to suppress human beings. It's to create a situation where the technology is talking to the brain, and telling the brain what to think and what.
And they sell it as enhancement. It's not that the technology itself would be bad. It's that the people running it, deploying it, rolling it out have made it a Trojan horse openly to dehumanize us.
Yeah, that's why, you know, my new book's called The Perception Deception, because that's what it all is. You know, we can talk about conspiracies involving banking and all these other things that we talk about, quite rightly. But you take this whole conspiracy, Alex, down to its base.
It is the Matrix. Stay there. I want to come back and talk about the book and what's at the bottom of the rabbit hole here with this whole perception deception. And that's it. They're trying to insert us into a false system. We'll be right back. David Icke always talked about the emergence point when the agenda gets too big and too open to deny. They go, oh, it is real, and if you don't like it, you're a terrorist. There is a world government. There is global taxes. We are going to put chips in your brain. And if you don't take them, you'll be like a bug we're going to step on, a.k.a. Ray Kurzweil. And then you see doctors saying under 2-year-olds should not have any screen time. It's brain damaging them. It's lowering IQ. Language is shrinking. Parents unaware of dangers faced by children on smartphones. BBC, this is the reality, ladies and gentlemen, and the drugging of the public and the chemicals, it's an undoubted, aggressive, evil, criminal agenda. And David Icke joins us. He was getting to the key point there, and he's been talking about this 20 years, folks, saying they wanted to hack the brain, create a false neural system, take over. Now, people say, well, he says it's entities in another dimension doing this. That sounds crazy. What does every culture say? Regardless of whether those entities are real or not, or that's some archetypal manifestation through people, I've been to Bohemian Grove. I've covered Skull and Bones. I know elitists. I grew up in the richest county in Texas, where all the rich people were basically devil worshipers. We had to leave the town because of it. Okay? I mean, it was unbelievable. The stuff they tried to induct me into. I've seen stuff by the time I was 14 that most people never even imagined. And I could see it was all part of my life, part of a journey to know this stuff's real. The police stealing drugs, you name it. This is a short segment, long segment coming up. I'm ranting, David. It's just that regardless, the elites do believe they're getting power from these entities. Go ahead.
Well, they are. I mean, you know, they're sick. And in terms of wisdom, they are without wisdom because cleverness and wisdom are not the same thing. Cleverness is a very much lower level of ability, of intelligence. But they're not in that cleverness area. They're not stupid in that sense. So they're not going to be all these centuries and right to the present day. They're not going to be worshiping something that is not there. But the whole point of which pulls all the strands together is the perception deception, because that is the crucial foundation. If you've got a target population of billions and you are, compared with that, a tiny cabal, and the core of it hidden in the shadows, then you can't control that population physically in total. You can start to get there the more you bring the population under mental control through drugs and various other means, like the transhumanist technology we'll come to. But we're not quite there yet. We're not there yet. So they still have a situation where they have to control a target population. And the only way you can do it is by manipulating their perception of self, of the world, of world events, of authority, so that that perception will suit your agenda for global control. And from perception comes what? Behavior and response, or in this world we live in, lack of response to what is going on. So you look at the education system, Alex, from this perspective, and it's a crucial part of the perception deception. Because, you know, you've got children increasingly from the earliest ages. I mean, you come out of the womb, Alex, and within, what, 3 years now? Suddenly you're in a school, which are nothing more than prisons now, and you're having an authority figure telling you what's right, what's wrong, what's possible and impossible, what you can do, what you can't do, when you can go, when you can't go. And more power is being given to school authorities and taken away from parents. And that's a massive perception deception element, because you then have control at least 5 days a week of that child and young person and students' information that they receive, basically. And what you're doing through a rigged curriculum with rigged versions of everything is that you are programming them to see themselves and the world and authority in the way that suits you. All this stuff now with the cameras, with the technology to get your dinner, you have to give a fingerprint technology, all these things, all police in schools, for goodness sake.
Stay there. 18-minute segment coming up, David. I'm going to come right back to you out of break. David Icke, davidicke.com. I want to read his new book because this is it. This is a war against reality, a war against consciousness, a war against free will, a war on perception to insert us in an artificial habitat kill grid. Briefly, everybody needs to be self-sufficient with gardens, buy local. The biggest thing you can do is go to mypatriotsupply.com/Alex. Non-GMO, organic, high-quality, storable food, what I choose for myself and my family. The highest quality, the best sponsor that we could possibly get with storable food. Very proud to have them. Top quality, top-rated customer service. MyPatriotSupply.com/Alex brought you this hour, 866-229-0927. You need to be self-sufficient, and this stuff lasts 25 years, so it's good to have it in case of an emergency. Also, it's all about not being disarmed. The globalists are doing everything they can to disarm the United States while they have an arms built up against us. And I get peace and not being offensive. I'm not an offensive guy. But the fact that we have guns is a real checkmate against their system. And the Molon Labe Greek 300 come and take it Maxim that was then used again in Texas in 1836 when the Mexican government dictator came to take the guns. They said Molon Labe, come and take it. We have put it out with the Greek Spartan helmet with two M4s crossed with the victory wreath around it. It says Molon Labe, come and take it, and under it, InfoWars. On the back, it has in the Greek letters, InfoWars. This is the way to spread the word, meek-minded people, and your purchase supports this broadcast. I think this is probably the most handsome T-shirt we've ever put out. Now, we've got a gold-foiled women's shirt, that gets here next week. It isn't up on the site yet, but that's, and it's formed, and oh, by the way, it's all made in America. I should have added that point on this for you. So I think, my God, this is going to be our bestseller ever. Your purchases support this TV system, this radio system, the filmmaking, the news sites, the 48 souls we got working on this operation. Our reporters in England, three of them. Our reporter in Washington State, the crew that's here. Our auxiliary reporters, PrisonPlanet.tv, the nightly news, all of it. So go to InfoWarsStore.com and get your Molon Labe. We got a lot of the great come and take it shirts as well, but this is the new made in 1776 Molon Labe T-shirts, and they're the best I've ever seen because I love Molon Labe shirts. And so it took us months to come up with this design, and it is available at InfoWarsStore.com or 888-253-3139 to get your Molon Labe shirt. It's an InfoWar. They're bombarding us with their images. We bombard them with the truth, ladies and gentlemen, that we are seeing tyranny rising. All right, listen, I'm going to give you the floor, or I'm going to keep jumping in here. David Icke, we're getting into the suppression of human consciousness. The fact is they want to, IQs are going down from the fluoride, Harvard study. We know they want to suppress us. They teach Common Core. You were talking about the state all over the world saying, your kids belong to us, 2 + 2 = 5. They literally are like O'Brien in 1984 in the United States with Common Core, 2 + 2 = 5, a huge crime against the children, screwing up their brains. What is at the bottom of the rabbit hole?
Well, like I was saying before the break, the education system is crucial to the perception deception because you have young minds who can be molded day after day after day after day. And one of the great testaments to human consciousness in its greater form is the number of young people who've been through that system. So many have, and it's got them. But there's so many young people that have been through that system and have still seen the truth of what's going on. So that's incredibly encouraging. So you've got education. Well, what passes for it? I mean, Gandhi once said, or was asked what he thought of Western civilization. And he said, I think it would be a very good idea. And I think education would be a very good idea. That's not what we've got. It's a programming operation to turn young minds into little more than software programs that respond in the desired way to inputted data, i.e. situations that they face. But then going alongside that, the education system, parallel with it, of course, is the mainstream media, which you and I have been challenging for a long time. And the mainstream media is constantly supporting the version of self, the version of reality, the version of the world that education is pumping out. So now there are, if you like, stereo versions of this programming, which young people are receiving, and indeed people in general in terms of the media, are receiving all the time. And that is constantly telling them a version of events which simply isn't true. But if people buy it, their responses and their behavior will walk straight into the hands of the agenda for global control. So the media is doing that. Then you have, and you've mentioned one or two things, then you have the toxic assault on the human brain and the human genetic structure, most notably through genetically modified food, which is there simply to genetically modify us. Then you you have things like growth hormones, which are given to cattle, which then cross over to humans. And so you have this big epidemic for that and other reasons of obesity, which again is taking people into a world that their bodies weren't meant to go into. I mean, just look back a few decades and see what it was like before. And then you've got the aspartame, then you've got the fluoride in the water, which are both brain suppressants and brain rewirers. And you put all this together, plus pharmaceutical drugs, plus the vaccines that are not only deluging the human immune system in young children before it's even formed, it's also affecting people mentally and emotionally, that toxic the cocktail that we call vaccines. So you put all this together, and there's absolutely a war from multiple levels on human perception. And there's another one. And that is, you know, in the last 50 years, the radiation in our atmosphere at the level that we play out our lives has increased by millions of times. Some open-minded scientists have called it an experiment on human life without knowing the outcome. But the people in the core, in the shadows from which it is coming, they do know the outcome. And part of that outcome is to, and this is where we come into transhumanism, this is where we come into the internet to a large extent, plus additions to the internet that are planned and indeed are now being talked about. I'll get to one of them in a second. Because the human brainwave activity operates at a certain frequency band. If you can access that frequency band with information delivered electromagnetically and electrically, then you are putting thoughts and perceptions and beliefs, perceptions of reality into that system, and the person is having thoughts and feelings and coming to conclusions that they think are their own conclusions, but they're not. And anything that's got smart in front of it is part of that grid. Smart televisions, which can look at you, smart phones, smart meters, smart grids. This is all part of it. And the idea is, I've been writing about this for years.
Smart growth.
Smart growth, smart cities, smart everything. Smart cars, they're calling
intelligent highways.
Yeah. So what's and of course the word smart is to give the underlying subconscious as well as conscious impression that this is the smart thing to do. This is the intelligent way to do it. There are benefits in this for you. There are not benefits for you. There is just control and suppression of your perception of reality and perception of the world. So you've got this. And for me, I've been writing about this for years. You know, the internet has fantastic benefits for getting this information out. I mean, you, me, and people like us would never have got the information out that we have to the number of people we have without the internet. But again, if you're going to sell a prison, then you've got to sell it as a beneficial thing. And up to this point, it has been. But as you know, and people following the story know, the idea is, and it's already unfolding in many, many different facets and faces, it's to take away the things that are beneficial for the internet, for people, the free flow of information.
That's right. They let it be free for a while, like a highway paid for by everybody's tax money. Then they hand it over to a toll road company. They're already starting with unified agenda worldwide to phase out the freedom.
Exactly. And so what's left when they do that, if we allow it, is the beneficial part of the internet for them. And that is as a massive mind programming, perception programming operation.
Spy grid.
Because for me, I mean, like I said, I've been saying this for years. What the internet is designed to be is an electronic collective mind for humanity. And this is where the transhumanism comes in, because the idea of putting chips into people and other pieces of kit that connect us to the internet, and of course, Google are at the forefront of all this stuff. Google's just the smiling face of DARPA at that level, the technological development arm of the Pentagon. That's why you have people like Regina Duggan, director of DARPA, moving to become an executive of Google. It's not brain science why that happened. They're expressions of each other. And so the idea is to connect us to the internet technologically, so the internet becomes our collective mind.
And let me throw this in. They're on record poisoning the environment and wrecking our genetics so that we've got to merge with the machines and the new medical systems just to survive the total form of true enslavement. And then they're there posing as the saviors when they've created the problem. Somebody's got to do something about it. And then they're there to give the solution.
Yeah, problem, reaction, solution. This was in the British press this week, Alex. Headline, forget the internet. Soon there will be the outer net. Company plans to beam free Wi-Fi to every person on Earth from space. Was in the London Daily Mail. They're quoting an organization called Media Development Investment Fund in the United States, which is among its funders are the Open Society Foundations of George Soros. You know that man that has.
Oh, he likes us.
And what they're saying is they want to beam it from space. Because they care about freedom of expression, you see, so they want to get over the restrictions in China and all this. They're such nice people, and give us internet.
They want to beam it into Russia, overthrow that, exactly.
Yeah. Now, what this is, I would suggest, and there'll be other things too, is another layer on, because the when I talk about the internet, what I'm also talking about is the lower levels of the Earth's atmosphere where we interact and live our lives. They want to fill that with so much electromagnetic information broadcasting within the human brainwave and genetic frequency that we are bombarded with basically a
frequency pollution, a jamming signal.
24/7 programming system. This is what smart meters are about. What are they doing? They're creating a Wi-Fi radiation field, yet another one. That's very kind, very sensible, thank you. Within every home and business, that's the idea with the smart grids. And you know, people have said, and rightly too, that what they're doing is being able to see when you open your fridge, how many people's in your house, what room they're in, what
exactly.
You're doing. Yes. But, you know, as they say on a motorbike, the throttle goes both ways. Well, so does the Wi-Fi. You can get information from a location and you can pick up that location.
No, that's on record. Let me expand on this. When I go to Big Bend, where I'd love to go live, but it's the middle of nowhere, you know, down in south west Texas on the Mexican border, and there's nothing on that side of Mexico either. Your cell phones don't work. Literally, even though I'm at 9,000 feet or whatever, I feel 20 years younger. It's like heaven because there's no Wi-Fi. But now it's not going to matter. They're launching blimps and satellites that are going to blast everything. And there's all these people moving to the countrysides in Europe and worldwide, as you know, to get away from frequency pollution. Sorry, you're not going to get away from it. Go ahead.
Yeah, well, this is what our point I'll come to in a second about trying to run away. You're not trying to run away. We've got to run straight at these people. Because if you're trying to run away, you'll run away for a while and then it'll catch you up. I mean, we've got to deal with it, for goodness sake. Don't run away from it. And so what is happening is that with the smart meters, that's another electromagnetic field, which is not only taking information from your home and business and delivering that to a central point, information's coming the other way. Within the frequency of human brainwave activity, so it can feed you impressions, it can feed you perceptions, it can feed you thoughts and beliefs. That's the idea. And what Hollywood is doing, I mean, what are we talking about? A perception deception, Hollywood, my goodness. It's one of the great vehicles for it. You know, I've been 50-odd countries everywhere you go.
That's where I wanted to go next, though. I want to stop you right there because I only got like 15 minutes or 5 minutes of the next hour with you, Max. DavidIcke.com joining us right now. Again, I'm Alex Jones. If you just tuned in, David, you know a lot of famous people. I know a lot of famous people. Most of them do not have the courage to go public. I mean, most big Hollywood stars, A-list, most big producers I know, 95% of them won't come on air. But a lot of them have come on air. And in Hollywood, it's not liberal or conservative. They're listening to you. They're listening to me. They're all awake. They hate the old shadowy producers, Sumner Redstone and others that won't let them tell the truth. There's a revolution going on in Hollywood. And I see it in the new Lego movie, in the new Nut Job movie, anti-establishment, how they want to program us. And that's not propaganda. There's a war going on, even in Hollywood. I mean, take Alice Walker of The Color Purple and all her big topics. Who's a listener of you, a listener of me. She promotes us, gets attacked. My point is that we're going to skip this network break, folks. We're going to skip another break. This is so important. David Icke, I'm saying we are on the edge of winning because this isn't fake. Almost everyone in Hollywood, I've now learned, is a listener of this show, and they talk about you as well. And I'm not on a power trip over that. This is the main enemy brainwashing base, and we, by the grace of the Creator and human consciousness and everything, and our listeners, we've not infiltrated them. They are in the programming system. They know the truth better than us. They're absolutely freaking out. The military's waking up because they're decompartmentalized with our information. This is incredible. So what do you want to say about that? Because I want to be clear, Hollywood is on the verge of a huge awakening and a revolution against the old guys that control it. David Icke.
Well, just take Hollywood, take any aspect of this global spider's web, and Hollywood will fit the blueprint. You've got a very few people that call the shots. And you've got everyone else that dance to the shots that are called. What has happened, thanks to the internet up to this point and books and many other, you know, vehicles, is that, yes, the compartmentalized structure is being decompartmentalized. Because before, there was no way that those in the compartmentalized structure could get access to information that only those they knew. So they were always in the dark. They were always a piece in a puzzle they didn't understand. They didn't realize there was a puzzle. They just knew that little piece and they thought that was it. What has happened? Because this information has circulated and circulated and circulated. And my goodness me, the number of people that are interested in it now is phenomenal compared with just a few years ago, even. Those compartments are breaking down because people lower down in the structure are going, hold on a second, when they hear this information, that makes sense of what I'm doing every day. That makes sense of why I was asked to do this movie and do this scene and read this script. But what I would say, Alex, you know, is yes, people are waking up, but you know, we can't just hold it at a point where we're waking up while still standing on the other side of the street, knowing more about what's happening and watching it with more understanding of the unfolding.
Yeah, it's kind of like being conscious while you're being roasted. It's almost worse if you don't reverse it.
We've got to cross the street and engage this, right? And there has to be a revolution of the many to refuse to acquiesce to the impositions of the few. And because, I mean, those people, I'll say to those people in Hollywood that are well off and have lots and lots of money, but are not part of this whole thing. They may be caught in it, but they're not part of it. I would say this to people in America and around the world who at the moment think that they're okay and they're well off and or comfortable and it don't really affect them. Well, hold on. There are people now in tent cities in America and homeless in the streets in places like Britain who not long ago considered themselves to be middle class and had a nice house and a big mortgage that which they could at that time pay. It turns very quickly because the where we're heading is what I call the Hunger Games society. And it's real simple. And my goodness me, can you not see it now? It's for less than 1% to control all wealth, land, water, food production, all of it, to have then a strata of uniformed programs, software programs called the police state with no ability to process information, just to respond to orders. Psychopaths, sociopaths, narcissists, we're seeing them being recruited on a personality basis rather than an ability basis all the time. And under that is planned to be everyone else in a slave masses with a major massive culling as well, which are subordinate. And those slaves will be subject to microchips and other forms of
forced inoculations. It's already happening. 200 square foot coffin apartments.
This is the point, Alex. When you realize and you know what's happening and you know where it's going, you read the world like an open book. This stuff now, you see these things where you swallow pills and have an edible microchip.
We told people that was coming.
Yep. Which then tell your mobile phone or your doctor's mobile phone when your next dose is due and if you've had it or not. That's all part of this process of forced drugging that this slave...
and they start it when you get allergy medicine over the counter now, swiping your card and telling you the state police are watching you. That's what the smart dust is about, the RFID, in their own words, a total enslavement grid. How do you think the fight against the spiders is going? How is the fight against the technocrats going?
Well, what I would say to everybody in Hollywood or elsewhere, we now have reached the point that pussyfooting around and doing a little bit and keeping your head down, yeah, I've watched the Alex Jones show, I read that David Icke's books, but I can't say anything because what about my career? Those days, ladies and gentlemen, are over if you have any desire to live in a world that even has a modicum of freedom. There's no more time for messing around and having it an add-on to your life. This is a time to stand up and be counted, to come out the big Hollywood names that are hiding in the shadows at the moment because they fear the consequences. I tell you what, the consequences of not dealing with this now are going to be far, far worse than...
exactly.
Or not doing it, the consequences...
Well, David, people tell me all the time, they go, thank you for your courage. I would have to have blind, crazy courage to not fight this. I'm fighting it because I know how horrible it is where they're taking us, just like you said. Wait, I'm not doing this because I have courage. I'm doing this because I want to survive and have consciousness and freedom and free will for myself and humanity. I hate bondage. I hate these psychopaths that, you know, the whole royal group that you expose, it's all come out and the dead bodies and the little kids and the BBC pedophile rings. I mean, my God, it isn't courage fighting these people. My very instinct says we need to absolutely rout them.
Yeah, the thing is, I mean, let's look at it. There was a point some time ago where this control grid was not what it is. The manipulation of perception was not as ingrained as it is becoming among large numbers of people who are not waking up. So as this moves on, more and more people who are not waking up become more and more programmed, more and more incapable of free thought and ever seeing what it is. So we can't wait until, because what happens, and I've talked about this before, is they push the gate. In other words, they'll push the agenda on. And if they don't meet resistance, then they'll walk through the gate to the next gate. And then this is how it moves on. So we have to, when are we going to draw a line in the sand? When are people, just use this analogy for now, but an analogy for humanity. When are the people in Hollywood that understand some of what's going on, and indeed some of them a lot of what's going on, how long are you going to stay silent? What, until there's a knock on the door? I mean, there won't be anyone around then. Come on, we have to get on with it now. And never in my 25 years nearly of doing this, never have there been more open minds to seeing this. People are opening their minds now to things they would have laughed and dismissed by reflex action before. This is a fantastic opportunity we're facing now. There was always a time when this was going to break the surface.
And we're here, we're alive now. David, do 5 more minutes with us. I know you got to go. I want you to tell us about your book and the TV network when we come back. Back in 60. Short break, folks. Stay with us.
This is
and Dr. Group in studio. Stay with us. It's my 40th birthday spending it with David Icke. This is fun. Well, the new book's available now, The Perception Deception. I definitely want to read it. David Icke is on target as usual. David, we only got 5 minutes left. I'm going to give you the floor here to talk about where you see this going and to talk about the TV network you've been in the arena launching so far successfully. But just briefly, getting into this, they know as the social engineers that we would respond like this. But so much of what they're doing is backfiring. I've learned that for every action, there's an equal and opposite reaction. They're not invincible. They know how to manipulate, but they don't have any heart, any guts, anything, because it is very unhuman what the establishment does. How are they going to counter the breakaway where people either become zombies or other people under attack, I find, are even becoming more enlightened as a spiritual but also genetic resistance. You could almost call it good mutation spiritually, you know, to use a strange term that I'm coining, that will actually cause humanity to hammer back.
Well, you know, to understand what's happening and how we're manipulated, we really do have to have a greater grasp of the nature of reality. And the body is a holographic projection of the true self, which is just consciousness, awareness. And if you get pulled, we see everything's about a point of attention. Your point of attention could be that wide, or it can be infinite. And if it's infinite, that point of attention is going to see everything from a massive, symbolically, it's going to see it from the top of the mountain, top of the hill. If your point of attention is pulled only into the five senses, you're only going to see the world that the five senses can decode and you can perceive, which is tiny. And so this whole idea of manipulating human perception is to pull our point of attention into the five senses. Can I see it, touch it, taste it? Hear it, okay, it must exist then. And transhumanism is taking that another step further because it's putting your point of attention even deeper into the non-expanded consciousness level of self and into the senses, into the technological senses in terms of transhumanism. That's what it's all about. And this kind of radiation, massive radiation field broadcasting within the human brainwave frequency is designed again to hold us in the five senses. Once you open your mind to your true self, consciousness, and start to think for yourself and not be aware of the way that we are programmed to respond and programmed to perceive, suddenly in the world is not little dots that aren't connected. The world is a tapestry that is so blatant.
And then you don't care about the system's world anymore. You see what a fraudulent, ugly mess it is, and then you're free from them, and then they can't be your masters. David, in closing, tell us about the book and tell us about the TV venture you've been launching.
Well, first of all, the book's The Perception Deception. It's nearly 1,000 pages. It's got 900 illustrations and images and 32 pages of original color art. And I'm coming up to my 62nd birthday, and I tell you, I have never done anything as important in my life.
This is your masterwork?
Yeah, absolutely. I couldn't be happier with it. And it's between two covers. It pulls it together. And it goes so deep in the rabbit hole. But it's not. Oh, that 1,000 pages? Oh, my goodness. No, it's a story. It has a beginning, a middle, and an end, as well as a massive amount of information. The People's Voice, the television network, which is global on the internet 24/7, I had the idea for that last May, and we got it to air on the 25th of November. It's not my television station. I was just a co-founder of it. This is just a vehicle to get this information out 24/7.
Absolutely.
Across the whole spectrum of subjects, everything from the conspiracy that we perceive in the daily events to the nature of reality, all these things.
It's the decoding center to empower free humanity. David Icke, thank you so much for the time. Look forward to talking to you again. And I'm coming to England to speak at Oxford soon, so hopefully we can hook up then. Maybe I can come in and be a guest on your system.
Now, we'd like that, because we got to work together. We do.
We're working together. You're awesome, David. Godspeed. All right, folks, we're coming back. Thank you. I guess the word is tutelage, and all my other mentors and friends, some that are here, some that are gone over to the next level, made the jump into hyperspace, but to all our friends out there in the real media, for all freedom lovers, for everyone that burns with a desire for justice and truth and liberty, I have just been honored to be alive and conscious and to be able to commune with my fellow humans and all the other great things on this earth, all the other life forms, everything. It is an incredible experience, and they want to immerse us in the false technotronic age, the false Times Square bombardment, and it's brain-damaging people, it's lowering IQs, it's hurting children, it's all on record. People say, well, why are you on TV then? Because you have to inject yourself into the Matrix to get to the people that are in the Matrix, and I live in it, and I certainly am a casualty at many levels from blowback. From being close to this. You know, be careful, as Nietzsche said, you stare into the abyss, lest you become the abyss. And I have learned the mind of the technocrats to a great extent, and believe me, it is unbelievable. When you study this as long and as deeply as I have, it's one cannot be told about the Matrix, one must see it for themselves. And we are in a science fiction movie. We're in a proto-Matrix they're trying to insert us into. And then you learn in 1977, it was declassified in 2001. It's in my book, Descent into Tyranny. And then they reclassified it, strangely enough. They do that sometimes. That the Pentagon came up with a plan with DARPA of how they would get us incrementally to accept computers, take over all communications, predict the future with it, track everything, and then have handheld computers, then goggles, then implants, ports, and then how we would literally give in to the false reality and give up on the real world as they made the real world as ugly as possible. Well, I can still go out with binoculars at night and look at Alpha Centauris or look at nebulas, ladies and gentlemen. I mean, there's beauty everywhere, even in the ugliness. And when you figure out this, it's like it is devilish. How does humans come up with a plan to suppress beauty and consciousness? I mean, it is blasphemous. It is unbelievable. And they talk about the earth, how they want to save it all day. All they want to do is kill, steal, and destroy. And you say, oh, that's the Bible. Notice, whatever it is, it's happening. And I'm not sitting here and go to these churches and find the truth. That's where the devil lives, is these big churches. Even if the devil isn't physically real or some dimensional entity, it doesn't matter. It's an archetype in humans manifesting in every culture and every time. But now, we can't have black pyramids they're sacrificing kids to every day, and then the culture gets so bad it collapses, people go back into the bushes and, you know, recongregate and create civilization again. Now they have all the weapon systems. Now there's all this technocracy and everything, and it could be like Atlantis any day. You know, the legend of Atlantis where the whole island blows up because they, you know, release some technology. Sounds like a hydrogen bomb. I mean, we don't know what's really gone on this planet. I mean, I'll tell you that right now. There's a lot of stuff going on here that we really don't know, but the Illuminati claim they do know it. And I think they do know, folks. the Alexandria Library, they've proven to not really burn. They got a bunch of it out and then burned it. And they know the real histories, and they're using this, and they're using it to cheat so they can run everything. And it's horrible. It's absolutely horrible. Now, for the balance of the hour, we're joined here by Dr. Ed Group, globalhealingcenter.com. I'm not going to go through all his laurels and titles and the rest of it, but he has a lot of gravitas, and he's not here to do a big InfoWarsLife.com pitch today, though that is how we fund our operation. We've got a 15% off Super Male Vitality, limited two-week deal we're going to run because it's become so popular. I want to lower the price for folks so they can get introduced to it, because to get these type of pure herbs that are so concentrated and so organic, and then to concentrate them like he does. Shane Steiner, by the way, got some of this like 2 months ago. He's like, oh, I'll take it. And he's a big sports guy. And he's like, my God, what is that? He came in here and got like 10 bottles the other day, bought 10 bottles. I mean, that's my good friend Shane Steiner. That's how incredible this stuff is, because we're already so bombarded with estrogen mimickers. We're already so chemically attacked. Mother Nature has the answers to counter this. And we could come out with a female one. It's the exact same thing as a gimmick, folks. It even works better for women. But the formula was made for men. We're going to tweak it a little bit and have one for women so they feel like it's like a pink package instead of a blue package. I mean, whatever. The point is, women, and we didn't put it out as an aphrodisiac. It just so happens that that's what these super herbs do, also do that as well. And I'll be honest, people, I only take half the dose because I already have anger issues. Sometimes it smooths me out. Sometimes I get I took some yesterday and I was bouncing off walls, folks, even though I had about 5 hours sleep. So Dr. Group joins us today to discuss all of this, but it is 15% off right now at InfoWarsLife.com. Limited time deal. That's InfoWarsLife.com on the Super Male Vitality. If people want to support the broadcast and try it out, or the Survival Shield, or the Fluoride Shield, or the Great Southern Mexico Organic Volcanic Soil Grown Chiapas Coffee. Now, Dr. Group, I wanted to get you in there a few weeks ago, and you said, I'm not ready. I want to do some more research and get something ready for people and talk about the top five health secrets. We're going to cover all five of them here, but you just taped with Gucciardi, Anthony, five separate parts to air the next 5 weeks on the Nightly News, where you go in depth, but let's get into the top five health secrets. None of us are perfect, but the journey of 1,000 miles starts with a single step. The top five health secrets that have been so incredible for you and your family. I mean, you look a lot younger than you are, and I've just been starting to follow your stuff finally, and it's having dramatic effects, as people can see on TV right now. I mean, I didn't even work out or anything for like 14, 15 years and ate like a pig and thought they were going to kill me any day and just didn't care. Until my buddy Tommy Pilata said, hey, you're already killing yourself for them because you've already decided they're going to come after you, so you don't care about your life. Care about your life. And I've been doing that, but it's in a slow process, but you've helped me supercharge it the last 6 months. Dr. Group, the guy behind InfoWarsLife.com, tell us the five health secrets.
Well, everybody always asks me, you know, what can I do? What's something simple? If you were to pick one thing, what would you pick? I mean, what's something I can change that's going to have a dramatic effect on my body right away? So my health secret number one is drink clean water. I mean, we've talked about, you talk about, everybody knows that the water's contaminated everywhere with fluoride, arsenic, chlorine. I mean, the list goes on, all the medications in the water right now, the radiation in the water from Fukushima. So if you think about it, the body, every living substance is composed of at least 80% water. The earth itself, all the plants, the humans. So if you take the human body and you look at it, what's happening with all these chemicals and these toxins are they're all contaminating the water inside of our body. So a very simple health secret or solution is to drink purified water. Drink something that's going to actually get rid of those toxins from
your body. And the enemy knows that and writes books how they're jacking the water. It's not our opinion.
Oh, absolutely. I mean,
pull up Harvard study, guys. Go ahead.
And the other thing is, there's a campaign to get people to not drink water and to drink other things that dehydrate you. If you ask the majority of people out there, I mean, basically 90% of the population is chronically dehydrated. What do they drink first thing in the morning? Coffee. Then they drink energy drinks throughout the day. Then they drink alcohol. Then they drink sodas with artificial sweeteners in them. I mean, most people have been conditioned now to not even like to drink water.
I read an article you wrote 10 years ago where you talked about artificial sweeteners, aspartame, making you fat. Now that's admitted.
Yeah, absolutely. And so what we need, it was all done by design to get people to not drink water. But another thing that was done by design was to sell people water, too. I mean,
you mean water like out of the toilet?
No, I'm talking
Aren't I supposed to only drink Brondo that plants crave? I mean,
well, they want you to drink the tap water, that's for sure, because it's just going to lead to more disease and everything else. But they want to get you away from... They want you to drink other stuff.
No, my point is an Idiocracy. Have you seen that movie?
No.
You got to see it, Mike Judge, genius. In Idiocracy, no one drinks water. They drink Gatorade called Brondo. And they think it's a conspiracy theory that they're even supposed to drink water. Water's only in the toilet.
Well, it's actually happening.
No, I know. It's incredible.
Yeah, it's actually happening. So, you know, with all the commercials and everything else that's out there leading you away from...
You're claiming we're supposed to drink water. That is a conspiracy. You're sick.
I know.
That's pretty weird.
Health secret.
Next, you're going to say babies need mother's milk.
Yeah, exactly. I am going to say that because the only thing the body needs and wants after breastfeeding is water. The body never tells you, hey, I want a cola or I want alcohol or I want any of this other stuff. The only thing the body needs and wants, scientifically proven, after breastfeeding is water and water only. But the water
that is so extreme and sick what you just said.
It is sick.
Everybody knows that they want Brondo.
Well, here's a solution. I mean, obviously, you want to get a good water purification system for your home if you can afford it and get rid of all the contaminants because you don't want to be taking a hot shower. You know, a 15-minute hot shower is the equivalent.
Skin's the biggest organ. You're breathing it.
Exactly. 7 glasses of tap water come in. But here's the secret. This is what I do, and this is what I recommend people do. Drink distilled water. Now, I used to think, you know, if you look up the science and, you know, years before, they say don't drink distilled water because it'll take the nutrients and the minerals out of your body. Right now, I think we have so many toxins that are contaminating.
We need to chelate.
That we need distilled water, but I don't recommend just anyone drinking only distilled water. What I recommend they do is they add organic apple cider vinegar into the distilled water. What that does is it's a very cheap solution to health. Organic apple cider vinegar has over 100 health benefits. It has live enzymes in it. It has nutrients, minerals, substances, the mother in there, it's actually alive. It's been shown to help regulate blood sugar, help with the heart, help with weight.
But I mean, why not be like Subway with plastic in the bread? Don't I need plastic, Dr. Group, petrochemicals instead of apples?
Well, in most bottled water.
Man, folks, we're far out there today. I want to apologize for this guest. Next is going to say that cows should only be grass-fed. You drink clean water, very extreme. Breathe clean air, that's number two. Health secret number two. On my birthday today, you gave me an air purifier for in here in the studio. You're so evil. Continue here. I mean, I thought they said the air was safe to breathe on 9/11.
Well, yeah, I mean, the air is just completely toxic anywhere you go. I mean, basically, we take 30,000 breaths every single day, and this is why breathe clean air is my second health secret, because indoor air is actually 10 times worse than outdoor air, and now you have, with the radiation fallout, you have chemtrails, which I've heard that there's even radioactive particles now being sprayed in the chemtrails, and the government's going to blame it on Fukushima, which is just a perfect scapegoat. The fact of the matter is the air's contaminated with fossil fuels and everything else. And the body takes a beating because all those toxins come in, they get stuck in the mucous membranes, leak down into the stomach, get absorbed through the intestinal tract. And so what you have to do is you have to counteract that. And the best way that I recommend people to counteract and to breathe clean air, you know, especially is to start in the home. I mean, look at all these memory foam mattresses people are sleeping on with all the fire retardants, the volatile organic compounds inside the homes, all the cleaning chemicals that are used inside the homes, the air fresheners. All this stuff emit toxic chemical gases inside the home that you're breathing nonstop. And all these contribute to excitotoxins that come into the brain.
Aren't those called eugenics vitamins?
They are eugenics. It's all part of the whole eugenics things. You can break them all down to, you know, volatile organic compounds, PCBs. I mean,
by the way, your dad was a famous chemist, so that's how you know about all this.
Yeah, my dad was a chemist, but he was in plastics. And still, I mean, even when you're talking about stuff like that inside the house, if you're cooking with Teflon pans, you're going to be releasing toxic gases. If you're
vitamins,
if you're cooking your food in the microwave in plastic containers, storing your food in plastic containers, you know, you can be breathing fumes. There's so many different fumes. You're using toxic pesticides and herbicides outside. You can be breathing all that stuff in.
No wonder cancer rates are up multi-thousand points.
Yeah, and I mean, a lot of times people's bedrooms are the most toxic things. They have pets and you have pet dander. you have mold and mildew in a lot of the homes that people are breathing in on a regular basis. You have so many toxins coming into the air that it's one of the, that's why it's my second health secret, is to clean up the air. What I recommend people do is they go to the local nursery, plant nursery, and they talk to individuals there and see what indoor plants work the best for their area. Ferns are really good.
How do we know, though, that people aren't growing marijuana? You know, and major cities are now doing inspections of gardens just in case. This is really, I don't know if I can recommend plants in the house.
Well, let me tell you what plants do in the house.
Oh, first don't. All, this is radical. Whoa.
Plants are going to absorb toxic compounds from the air. Ferns even absorb toxic chemicals and metals.
Will a plastic Christmas tree work?
No, it won't. Sorry about that. Because you're going to be inhaling all the plastic fumes and the volatile organic.
That's kind of racist against plastic Christmas trees.
Well, they shouldn't be producing plastic Christmas trees anyway.
Why are you discriminating against the Christmas trees?
You should just get a live plant for Christmas or something like that. But anyway, you know, that's a whole issue with, you know, do I cut down a tree and use it for a Christmas tree? Or do I get a fake tree? But what they should be doing is using other compounds that are safer instead of plastic to manufacture.
Or lighting a bureaucrat on fire in your house.
Silicone or something like that.
I'm joking.
But anyway, just by putting 3 live plants in every single room of your house, because plants increase the oxygen content in the air too. And just by doing that, you're going to be cleaning up your house. And then, of course, eliminating all the toxic chemicals and household cleaners and everything like that. But really, I tell people, focus on your home and your office first. And even get a whole house air purification system like the Remy unit, or like the one that I gave you. And that's not my company. I'm not affiliated with them. But that was the only company's air purification system that produces ionized hydroperoxides in the air. And it was the one that was used by China when the SARS epidemic came out. What I love about it is you could put it in your HVAC system and it actually cleans all the air throughout all your vents and it comes down into the rooms.
And it's key to change your filters out a lot.
Yeah, clean your air filters out and just make an environment, a non-toxic environment.
Because we've been taught not to care about ourselves. Like, it's kind of cool to not change the filters. It's kind of cool to die of cancer early.
Yeah, I mean, what you could do, too, is you could put those little Himalayan crystal salt lamps around, you know, that produce the little salt fumes into the air. You can use aromatherapy diffusers to kind of clean the air in your home. But it's really important to clean the air in your office and your home. And the next time that you get carpeting in your house, or the next time you paint the walls in your house, you want to use organic or wool or some sort of something that's low VOC or free of VOCs, and slowly start cleaning the air quality in your home.
All right, we've covered 1, drink clean water. That's an extreme conspiracy theory. And under the fairness doctrine, I want to say those are his opinions, okay? He says you want clean air. That's his opinion. I want to be fair here with the government. Airtime. They go, you know, your show's not even radical anymore. In fact, it is kind of passe because it's just everything's coming out. It's getting more insane by the minute. And it's because the establishment is now above the law, as Obama got caught saying with the French president today. They're walking out to do a press conference. They had a shotgun mic on him. He goes, I'm the president. I can do anything I want. And then the French president, they've all got Swiss bank accounts and are above the law of 100% tax rates on the middle class. They're literally criminals and they're megalomaniacs. And if you study criminology, Dr. Group, as I know you have, this is a standard deal in criminals, is they start thinking they're invincible. But now they've got all these weapons, they may destroy us. I mean, it's so insane. But little old Alex Jones at Infowars.com is giving them trouble. That's come out with the White House. DrudgeReport.com, because they cover real news. They're freaking out about them 24/7. Look at these stories up on DrudgeReport.com. New bill would mandate kill switch for smartphones. Authorities could hijack technology to stifle dissent. Apple already built this into their phones 2 years ago without even being asked. But now they want to make it the law. In California, where they hit one button, SB962, and kill all the phones. That shows the Trojan horses built in. And the Trojan horses in the food, the water, everything. Another story up on DrudgeReport.com. He's wearing a diaper. TSA agent humiliates cancer victim in front of witnesses and then made fun of the cancer survivor's diaper. And I've been made fun of by TSA bureaucrats. They're not agents. And I've seen them do it to other people. And my grandmother on crutches when they went to a wedding in Mexico, when my cousin wanted to have her wedding down in Mexico, and they yelled at her, were mean to her, and said, hurry up, you old lady. And my dad, who was with her, it's not his mom, it's my mom's mom, but he loves her as much as his late mom, literally said never in his life that he almost punched someone, you know, in the government. But he almost, you know, it was like these people screaming at her hatefully. This is how sick it's getting. And it shows just a poisoned, mentally ill group. I want to get back in to number one, clean water, how to do it. Number two, breathe clean air. Then number three, number four, number five in a moment. But what do you think's happening culturally right now with all this insanity? Because people are either going completely insane or they're waking up. What do you think's going on, Dr. Group?
Well, one of the things that's happening is as people clean their body and they understand what you're talking about and they understand where all these chemicals and where they're being attacked from, at least they're waking up and they can do something about it because there is a solution to every problem. If you understand the poisons in the water and you drink clean water, that's a solution. If you understand they're poisoning the food and you're eating clean food, that's something else. And then when the fluoride and when the calcification of the pineal and when they start eliminating all the MSG and the excitotoxins, they start waking up. I mean, when it's your body is consumed with all these chemicals and all these toxins and all these eugenic things, it really causes non-aggressiveness, it causes non-motivation, and as you clean your body and as you become aware, like what you're saying, people are waking up and it's not so conspiracy anymore. It's becoming mainstream. Because people are finding out, and the government's in a last-ditch effort right now, I think, because they're just using every single resource that they can to try to control, to watch us, to do everything, because they know and they can see that the word's actually getting out there and that we're actually trying to help people and we're giving people solutions, and people are waking up and more people are coming forward and talking to their senators and their legislators and everything else to try to do something about it.
I was joking about it earlier because we make the jokes that you're the Green Beret doctor here at the office, but of course they didn't call it Green Berets after Vietnam, but you were in Army Special Operations and did a lot of secret stuff on the North Korean DMC and a lot of other stuff. You and Weldon have really hit it off, talking about stuff he did over there in the Air Force. But why do you think they say the number one enemy is veterans? And does that offend you as a veteran, 7 years in the U.S. Army before you went and got your degrees? Does that offend you to have them saying you're the enemy? And why do you think they say you're the enemy?
I think that they say that the veterans are the enemy because, you know, they're scared of the veterans in a way because there's so many veterans. My phone rings off the hook with post-traumatic stress disorder and all these veterans that are actually waking up to what's going on with them being used as experiments for injections of different compounds when they have no say-so, when they're going through the lines. It happened to me. I don't know what it was injected into me at different times. I think that if you look at the meals ready to eat in the military, you know, the way that they use hormone disruptors, sterility products on military personnel, the way that the depleted uranium in throughout Afghanistan and everything is exposing the military personnel, Gulf War syndrome, when they're all this stuff that the military are bringing back. I think that we have a smarter veteran group right now, a smarter military, because I see more and more military personnel asking questions about, hey, wait a second, why are they doing this to me? And I see, you know, even with the government coming out and saying, you know, will you fire on citizens and asking military personnel, will you fire on citizens in the military? I think they're worried about a coup. I mean, a military coup, and the veterans may be joining in on that.
No, they're definitely worried about that. And they want to replace the military with robots as quickly as possible.
Yeah, exactly. So, I mean, I think that, you know, for the first time over the last 5 or 10 years, you know, especially over the last 5 years, with the amount of information that you're putting out there and with the internet and with people actually being able to cross-reference things and actually see that this isn't just stuff that you're talking about and that we're saying, because I talk about the same thing. Look, you know, first I'll say, yeah, fluoride is damaging. It's an endocrine disruptor, blah, 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 blah. It's going to shut down your thyroid. It's going to lead to all these conditions. They think I'm crazy because they're like, well, how can that be? It's in the toothpaste. It's in the mouthwash. They have water out there with fluoride.
It's hidden in plain view.
Water. Now, I just said, look, just do your own research on it. Vaccine issue. I mean, everything, you know, everything we're talking about, but people are actually, they're hearing it from their friends now. It's like their friends are talking about it. People in their circles are talking about it. People are actually waking up and they're seeing the results too of the people that are actually doing something about it and greening their home. In other words, getting rid of all the toxic compounds and stuff.
Real greening, not to pay Al Gore money on carbon.
No, exactly. Yeah. I mean, they're actually aware and they're not buying the Roundup and they're not buying the toxic chemicals and they're cleaning their body on a regular basis. And they're detoxifying their home. They're paying more attention to what they're giving their kids.
Were you awake to all this stuff when you got out of high school and joined the military and then went to college? I mean, when did you wake up?
I actually woke up to it in a weird way because I had studied pharmaceuticals and everything, and I was kind of brainwashed into calling everybody else a quack until I met somebody. Originally, I wanted to be a medical doctor and be a heart surgeon. That was my dream, and that's what I was studying, and I was brainwashed. I met a guy that was treating cancer naturally, and we kind of got into a little argument. You know, I was brainwashed to think that natural medicine was all quackery and stuff like that, and he looked at me. He said he knew I had a background in chemistry and biochemistry, and he said, fine, I'm not going to argue with you. Pick any prescription drug you want and tell me how that does any good on the body. I said, all right, that's not a problem at all. I mean, we wouldn't have prescription drugs if they weren't good for us. So I went to the library, brought out all the biochemical books, chemical books, took a couple prescription medications, broke them down chemistry-wise, looked at how they work on the body. And in about 2 hours, that was my wake-up call. That's when just like everything opened up. I saw it. I had like a vision, and I saw the damage that was being done worldwide with pharmaceuticals, that they're not designed to do anything but cover up a symptom, cause a malfunction.
Can you talk about your dad on air and the bisphenol A?
Yeah, I can talk about my dad on air, sure.
Tell people briefly about him.
My dad was a chemist. He was one of the top chemists for Exxon, actually, and he did his dissertation for his PhD.
Yeah, we looked him up. It's pretty amazing.
Yeah, I mean, so basically, he was a co-inventor of Saran Wrap, and he was like the leading guy and the leading chemist on plastics. I mean, he was the one that was going around teaching and lecturing about how plasticizers, epoxy resins, anything that had to do with plastics. He actually worked for the government. I don't know what he was doing when the Reagan administration, I know he was involved with the drug war, putting something in the chemicals they were using to make cocaine with. And recently, I know when he died, it was a very fast death. And I was always wondering, because I remember a group of people that like all these guys showed up at my mom's house with these documents and like forcing her to sign this stuff. And he was dead within, like he had throat cancer and spinal cancer, and he was dead within 2 weeks. And I was like, how does that happen? You know? And at that point in time, they just offered her a bunch of money. My mom, it wasn't a bunch of money. I think it was like $120,000 or something like that. She signed up off all these documents. All of his records were sealed. In other words, through Exxon, nobody could get access to him. I found out only about 6 months ago that he was about to go public right before he died with reversing all of his original research. Because this whole time I'm thinking, oh my gosh, I can't believe my dad was involved in plastics, and now I'm trying to clean up all this stuff. It's really weird how that works. But I just found out that he was about to publish a bunch of reports on the damaging effects of plastics, and he was involved with some research at some, you know, agency, and they were finding that these plastic compounds they were developing were causing cancer in animals, and it was probably one of the most toxic for humanity, for the environment, and for humanity. And he was about to go public with this research. And then, you know, I think he was killed off. And that's the story of my dad. And, you know, now we're talking about all the toxic, you know, effects of plastics everywhere. You know, we talked about water. We're about to
look at how they put plasticizers in the bread illegally. It's illegal everywhere else.
Yes, it's illegal everywhere else. And now, you know, now that Subway came out and said that they're going to actually take it out in the United States. But we're talking about food. That is health secret number three, which is eat clean food. I mean, we know the food is contaminated. It's another eugenics system. The food is being man-made. It's genetically modified, which causes the BT toxin to be produced in the human gut, which burns holes through the intestinal lining, which leads to all kinds of allergies, leads to all kinds of other problems in the system. You have pesticides in foods, insecticides in food. You have dead food. I mean, we're actually herbivores in nature. You know, we're not really carnivorous. We've kind of, you know, evolved into that, but a carnivorous animal has canine teeth to rip and chew flesh. We don't. Secretes hydrochloric acid in its mouth. We don't. Has a pipe-like digestive system. We don't. And, you know, if you look at a carnivorous animal,
we're not even really omnivores.
No, we're herbivorous in nature, and we're designed to eat. You know, we don't have a pipe-like digestive system, and we're supposed to eat more live fruits, vegetables, and stuff like that. But we've been conditioned to not do that and to eat all these toxic chemical-ridden foods. Now, with meat having all the hormones injected in them, it takes 3 years to get a calf ready. 1 year instead of 3 years to get a calf ready. The containment, there's 500,000 cattle, you know, butchered, you know, every week, I think, something like that. The point of the matter is, it's very simple. The way that we change everything in society is we just don't buy it. You know, if you don't buy the chemicals, you know, household cleaners, then they go out of business. If you don't buy the toxic foods, they go out of business. You know, you force them into producing organic things. I mean, the demand for organic foods, the demand to not sell foods that are genetically modified.
It's a model of success for everything else.
Yeah, we're actually starting to see it work. I mean, just look what happened with the Subway thing with the plasticizers in the bread, the petition that the Food Babe did. Now
we launched that on this show.
Exactly. Now all of a sudden they came out and they're taking it out. It takes that grassroots effort from everybody to step forward and to not support these chemical, you know, the industrial complex, you know, the medical industrial complex with pharmaceuticals and everything else. And we're seeing that people are turning away also from the prescription drugs too, and they're looking for natural alternatives, especially with this Obamacare disaster that's coming in. So my solution is, as far as the health secret number three, which is eat clean foods, is avoid GMOs. The best way to do that is to avoid anything that has corn and soy in it, of course, because that's also going to be, you know, the soy is going to be another estrogen disruptor. And to go organic, you know, eat organic. If you can't afford organic, go to your local farmers markets. I mean, every city has one.
Well, people are buying so much organic, it's going down in price now as it creates a market. Now, moving right along to number four, reduce your stress levels. Boy, this is one I could follow.
Yeah, I mean, you know, this is a health secret number four, which is one of the things that I think is so damaging, because when you look at, you know, everybody, a lot of people walk around, there's so many people on antidepressants now. Kids are being put on ADHD drugs right now. They're thinking that it's just some weird thing that people are born with that's crazy.
I guarantee you, if this continues, it'll be a conspiracy soon that everyone wasn't always on it. It'll be like, I heard people didn't used to all be on this. That's a lie. That's the criminal, the evil terrorist says
right.
That.
We remember a day when there wasn't people on anti-anxiety, ADHD drugs, or I remember a day when there wasn't any such thing as ADD, ADHD, which are all created to sell you
They
more
put
drugs.
Us in an artificial environment, you. The bad food, the dyes. People start freaking out. Their answer is, here's these drugs that on record for most people make it worse and are incredibly toxic.
Well, here's what causes depression and stress and anxiety and ADD and ADHD. What causes it is the electromagnetic frequencies, the radiation people are exposed to through cell phone towers everywhere, the chemicals in the food, the chemicals in the water, the chemicals in the air. They're all neurological degradation compounds. They're excitotoxins. They either excite the nerves. I mean, if you put a drop of aluminum and mercury on a nerve tissue in the brain,
kills it.
You can see how fast it completely fries it and denatures it. So,
hey guys, pull up mercury in brain cell, University of Calgary. It'll come up. It's on YouTube. Just mercury brain cells video. Go ahead.
So it's not that people are suffering from depression and anxiety and ADD, all these mental disorders. It's the fact that they're being caused by all these chemicals and toxins and everything else.
Which they know. I mean, you go to public school, it's Twinkies, Cokes. You're going to have a sugar crash. You're going to bounce off the walls. I mean, it's like if I gave my kids that stuff, I take them to a birthday party. It's the only time they're bad is after a piece of cake. They act like demons.
Right. I mean, so another thing with cleaning up your food is don't drink high fructose corn syrup or don't eat it. You know, avoid the artificial dyes, the artificial colors. Avoid the white flour, which has bromine in it instead of iodine, which it used to have in there. Avoid gluten.
And folks, you're going to find when you've been on this bad stuff for a while, as soon as you start eating regular, real food, it's almost weird and you're kind of like, because the poisons are addictive. But as you start to phase it out, which I've slowly done, my problem is I work too much, don't sleep. I mean, it's crazy, but I'm reversing so much of it. And it's amazing.
Well, that is the solution to, and the more people that actually do that, the more people that become awake. You know, you talk about increasing the consciousness and eliminating the amount of toxins on a regular basis is what increases the consciousness.
Watch what mercury does on that TV screen of your TV viewer. They put mercury into the solution and then it just hammers it down and kills it. They haven't released it yet. They release it here in just a moment. Boom. That's what some loving mercury does for you.
Yeah, and not only that's just mercury. When you combine that with other chemicals and metals, it even gets it exponentially gets worse.
Oh, the government loves me. Come on. People should take the challenge and get a bottle of it and try it and see what it does. Women can take it as well, as you've said, and break down what these organic, purified, concentrated herbs do. Because you last time you were on, you talked about the estrogen stuff. This is a way to block that out as well.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, the fact of the matter is we're living in an estrogen-dominant society, and I wanted to give back to the men out there and help balance the women as well, because, I mean, there's so many estrogen mimickers. There's so many things that decrease the amount of testosterone, growth hormone, DHEA in men and women, and there's really nothing out there that's natural. I mean, now the big push for HRT is pharmaceutical-based because they want everybody on testosterone.
Yeah, they take our hormones away and then we have to go buy them back.
Yeah, I mean, who knows where those hormones are coming from anyway? And it's not good to put the hormone in the body because then your body stops producing it if you keep it in there for a period
of time. That's right. These herbs that you put together, you were saying, just makes the glands naturally turn back on.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, that's the whole purpose of it. What I wanted to do is bring together some rare herbs in a powerful therapeutic dosage to naturally stimulate and balance the hormone production, the natural hormone production in males and females. So that's what it was designed to do. And with the technology that we have, with the nanotechnology and the extraction mechanism that we have to where we can extract 98% of the herb material and we can use that in a synergistic or a balanced approach and concentrate it, you know, you're going to get almost the equivalent of a pharmaceutical, but a natural product, which is made with organic stuff, which is not going to harm you over a period of time.
Man, I tell you, the three products you helped us develop, we tracked down the coffee after years ourselves in Mexico, that are InfoWarsLife.com. I mean, it's just nothing but positive reviews. And I've promoted other supplements that are great as well, InfoWarsHealth.com. They're wonderful. But, I mean, I've never seen anything like this with InfoWarsLife.com. I mean, the stuff you help us put together, it's phenomenal. Because I did a lot of research. You know, what is the best? What is the best? What is the best? And I took the proprietary blends before they were mass-produced myself. I was like, whoa. Like you said, I had the detox the first month with the iodine. I'd take another iodine. Didn't do this. Other iodine hurt my stomach. Made me hurt when I peed. This doesn't do that. And how do you come up with all this? It's just,
well, first of all, I don't produce anything unless I would take it myself, and I use it myself, and I test it on myself, and it takes a long time. I mean, the Super Male Vitality was something I was working on for 7 years. It just so happens that you came along, and at the same culmination of we're having all this feminism, and we're having all these problems, and this with hormones and functioning hormones. There's just no solution out there, so it was more, let's see if we can put this thing together and with the R&D behind it and see if we can make something that actually works that we can...
Because we were talking about this almost a year ago, and it took just a few months ago and then months to get it produced, and then the right herb didn't come in from the Himalayas. It just goes on and on, but we finally got it.
Yeah. Whenever I develop products, I want to make sure they're the best in the world, guaranteed. And no.
And you use the raw herbs, not dried, when you can.
I use everything that's non-irradiated. We'll go, you know, check out where it's grown, do microbial screening on it, make sure it's pure, make sure the constituents are at their highest level. We even check all the raw materials with Geiger counters when they come in just to make sure they're not contaminated.
And by the way, you've got your own incredible laboratories and factories in New Mexico and here in Texas, but what's even in Arizona, but what's even more incredible is that it's so powerful compared to other stuff I've taken. And it's my product, so I'm just so honored to be working with you. Folks, 15% off, limited time on Super Male Vitality, InfoWarsLife.com. Try it, get a bottle. Regardless, you'll be supporting the transmission. We're going to run this special for 2 weeks, InfoWarsLife.com or 888-253-3139. You can call it reap what you sow, karma, whatever you want. I only believe in bringing you the best. I get off on it. I'm going to be quite honest. It's about a win-win. InfoWarsLife.com. I'm going to hit the final 2 points when we come back in overdrive. InfoWars.com/show. It's Dr. Edward Group in studio with us. The Green Beret.
Gallonage.
Homeland Security just announced another 141,000 rounds of ammo, sniper ammo, to add to their 2.5 billion. Dr. Ed Groups here. Truth is, the globalists have stolen everything under the sun. They've totally taken over with fraud and derivatives. They want to keep it all while making us poor to control us, while poisoning us. They're just a bunch of jerks. And, you know, we try to do what we can do here. Getting into it. So eat clean foods. Let's hurriedly hit. Okay, we hit reduce your stress levels. What about secret number five? Cleanse your body and environment. This is the big one.
Yeah, it is the big one. I mean, just we didn't give the solutions for the stress levels. I mean, one of the best ways to reduce your stress levels is actually bringing yourself from a sympathetic state into a parasympathetic state. Parasympathetic state is when your body's calm and not in a high level of stress. Everything is designed to keep you in high level of stress, whether it's media driven, whether it's chemical driven, anything. They want you stressed out because they know when you're stressed, your body goes into a stressful situation, yeah, and your immune system is immediately dropped by 50% when you're in a state of stress. You know, you have a hard time having bowel movements, and if you can't have bowel movements, as a matter of fact, the average person out there has two bowel movements a week. That's because they're so stressed out all the time. So 9 deep breaths is the fastest way.
I heard Hillary's never had a bowel movement. That's why she looks like a Jabba the Hutt, stuffed with dead rats.
I tell you what, if you look at everybody in Washington, I don't think anyone's had a bowel movement in a long time up there, unless they have some secret compound that they're using. But, I mean, the fact is, you don't want that stress to affect you, because stress is one of the initiators of disease to cause you to have these situations.
So you want to
go into the doctor's office for your stress, and then you're getting on all
the key is goblin power.
The key is meditation power. The key is reducing your stress power, taking some time for yourself, learning how to, instead of living in fear, anxiety, jealousy, resentment.
Well, what do you call the stress, though, where I get into fighting the enemy and get all excited and run around in circles?
There's two types of stress. There's distress and there's eustress. Eustress is good stress, because there is good stress, and distress is bad stress. If it affects you negatively, like your body, your biochemistry negatively, then it's distressed, it's bad. But you can get excited about something, just like I'm excited about talking about this right here with you today. That's eustress. That's good stress. People thrive on that. I mean, that's what gives you the...
We're almost out of time.
You can wake up.
We got to hit to cleanse your body.
Okay, health secret number five, keep the inside of your body clean on a regular basis. I mean,
the Bible says keep your temple clean.
Look, you can get any text from thousands and thousands of years ago, any society, and there's always cleansing. There was fasting. People would fast for a certain amount of times. People would go on water fast. People would always cleanse the inside of their body. The earth cleanses itself on a regular basis. You wash the outside of your body when you take a shower every day. But what are you doing for the inside of your body? All this stuff builds up and builds up and builds up over time.
That's where the fluoride shield comes in.
That's when the fluoride shield comes in. That's when the survival shield comes in. That's where all the health...
But like you said, exercising, steaming, and then you've also developed the proprietary oxygen tablets.
Like intestinal cleansing on a regular basis, liver and gallbladder cleansing, parasite cleansing, which we haven't even talked about, chemical and heavy metal cleansing. I mean, there's stuff out there that you can find online, but the whole purpose is that you know that the health secret number five is not only keeping the inside of your body clean, but also keeping your environment clean. And we talked about that with the air purification, the water, the inside of your house. Anything that you buy, look at it and say, is this something that's toxic? Do I understand what these ingredients are? And then switch from chemical toxic ingredients over to natural non-toxic.
And it's a process. Nobody's perfect. It's taken me years to try to pull out of this, but it's getting better and better.
You start climbing up the stairs of health, even if you're going up one stair at a time, instead of staying still or going down. See, 90% of the people out there, every single day, they go down one step to a poorer health. What I'm talking about is... start going up one step every single day.
Great job, Dr. Group. Thanks for driving in from South Texas out there at your ranch. And thanks for doing the talks for the InfoWars Nightly News. It's coming up tonight, 7 o'clock. Great job, Dr. Green Beret.
Happy birthday, too.
Thank you, buddy. That's it for the big 4-0 transmission. Love you all.